Masturbation feels normal, but are you using it in a way that is hurting you instead of helping? Masturbation mistake number one, edging without release. If you are staying at the edge of climax without finishing, it might feel to you like an exercise in control, or maybe it's a way to extend the experience. But on a neurological level, something else is happening. Every time you get close, your brain floods with dopamine. This is the same neurochemical that your brain uses to signal, this matters, this is important, keep going. But when the cycle keeps repeating, buildup without completion, your dopamine system stays active much longer than it was designed to. Over time, this can change the way your brain and body respond. On the left, you see a balanced reward system. On the right, after repeated edging, you can see reduced sensitivity. That means the same activity doesn't feel as strong anymore. The result? You, a physically healthy man, end up with sexual arousal dysfunction, SAD, namely ED. This isn't just happening to you. It's happening at epidemic levels to physically healthy men. Mistake number two, masturbating to fall asleep. You might use masturbation as a way to relax before going to bed, as part of your nightly routine. It might seem helpful, an easy way to wind down after a long day. But here's what happens biologically. While there can be a short-term release, the underlying brain performance pattern tells another story. When dopamine is released in this type of brain activity, it doesn't automatically shut off. Your brain's reward system stays active, keeping you more alert than you might realize. Alongside of dopamine, there's often a cortisol spike. That's the stress hormone in your system. Instead of easing into deep, restorative sleep, your brain and nervous system stay active in an agitated but perceptible way. What feels like a quick, easy way to relax might actually be disrupting your body's natural recovery rhythms. Mistake number three, using porn with masturbation. Porn might be a small or large part of your masturbation routine. For many people, it's that way. It's widely available, endlessly novel, and designed to grab your attention right away. But what's very important to understand is that repeated exposure to this type of overstimulation can gradually change the response patterns in your brain. Your brain is constantly learning, wiring itself or miswiring itself. The more it associates arousal with fast-paced, screen-based, distorted artificial sexuality instead of real human connection, the more it wires itself in to need that within the neural pathways. Over time, this can make real-world intimacy with a human partner feel less stimulating, boring, not arousing enough. It can be difficult to engage emotionally with a partner. Instant gratification becomes easier than the delayed gratification of putting in the connection. It's not about morality, it's about what your brain adapts to. When genuine connection requires presence, patience, and subtlety, the screen can offer you high intensity, immediate gratification without the work. When that becomes the norm, regular experiences won't do it for you anymore. They don't have enough to offer. Mistake number four, normalizing daily habit. Okay, so maybe masturbation has become a normal part of your day, not as a choice, but as a habit. It has for so many people. It feels normal, automatic, almost like brushing your teeth or checking your phone, but frequency matters. When an activity stimulates high levels of dopamine over and over every day, your brain adjusts. It starts producing less baseline dopamine on its own because it starts expecting that high-level external hit. Over time, this can lead to what's called baseline dopamine depletion. Instead of feeling motivated and energized naturally, there's this persistent feeling of flatness, mentally, emotionally, and even physically. The key thing to remember is just because something feels normal doesn't mean it's optimal. In many cases, something that feels routine to you is the exact case where your brain is struggling to keep up with it. Mistake number 5, thinking it's harmless stress relief. You probably turn to masturbation to wind down and relax after a long day. That's how most people use it. It's a form of stress relief. Alternatively, many men use masturbation to charge themselves up in the morning, just to get going. And in the moment, it can feel like it's working. Tension drops, focus fades, everything becomes quieter. But here's what the science shows. The feeling of relief is related to a dopamine spike, your brain's quick release reward chemical. The spike is temporary. Over time, it becomes a repeated pattern. Your brain adapts. It starts relying on the quick hit instead of building resilience through deeper, more structured stress management systems. The result? Long-term stress intolerance. Things that used to feel completely manageable now become stressful and overwhelming. And without realizing it as it's happening, you find yourself locked into a cycle. It goes like this. Using the habit to escape stress, but the habit itself makes it more difficult to cope. Your classic downward spiral. These 5 mistakes aren't just bad habits. They're silent brain killers. If you're ready to reset, commit to 7 days. No porn, no masturbation. Track your brain, energy, track your life. It will change everything. If you want to see real-time measurable results in your brain, go over to drtrishleigh.com. I have the tools for QEEG brain mapping. I can show you exactly what's happening in your brain. I have helped thousands of people break the cycle and find real-world pleasure again. Have you made any of these mistakes without really realizing the impact on your brain? If you have, drop it in the comments. I read everyone. And if you need clarity, I'm happy to answer any of your questions, maybe even make you a video. Now that you know what's happening in your brain when you masturbate, click on the video that's coming on the screen now so you can learn more about the difference between masturbation versus real sex. It'll shock you. Right now is the time, my friend, to elevate your mind over explicit matter. Let's go.